So this is how basically my setup looks like. This is one camera, this is the other camera, this is my VTX, and this is the board. The connections are very simple. You see, I got camera 1 connected to the pin 1 in 1, and camera 2 connected to input 2. The power and the ground are basically the same for both cameras, and they're directly connected here. The board accepts everything from 3 to I think 6S. But what I've did is I connected it to the clean power from the VTX, where I get only 5 volts in the ground. So basically that's all done. So my cameras are taking the same voltage from the VTX, as and also you can see that in the DVR, it's extremely clean, the video. The output from this board is basically, depending on which camera it's on, it's that one. It goes, of course, directly to your board. It's connected to my board, goes through the OSD, and from there goes out directly to the VTX, and VTX send it to your goggles. Straight and forward. Here's nothing to explain. What is interesting is here, this signal wire, and that's what gives the signal so that the board can detect and switch between the cameras. This, I connected it to the TX1. You can connect it to any UR, just basically what you have free. And then here is the trick, here is what you have to do. You have to assign this pad to pinIO. This is basically, since Betaflight 3.3, you can assign any pad a pinIO, which is digital on and off switch. Just look at it like that. That's how I understand it. Of course, probably you can assign even more complicated stuff, but I don't know any of these. So, how do you assign it? Basically, what I followed was the instruction on Bicks' website. This is the website stored at Bicks.us. And when you go, here is the product. Here is basically this super mini tiny chip. You go to the attachments, you see the manual. I already downloaded the manual. And the instructions are extremely clear. Basically, it's very simple. What you have to do is you have to free one of the pins, which you're gonna use for the pinIO. I used my serial TX1, which was at A09. And what I did is I copied this, or just connected to 6. I mean, just whatever, which one you want. What you gotta do is resource serial TX, in my case was 1. I pasted none, and it will give you 3. Okay, let's go and do this straight in Betaflight. What you type is resource. Here are resources, you can see 1, it's already 3. So let's do this on the second one, okay? So you copy all of this thing, copy it, paste it down there. Okay, and what you wanna type here is none. When you type none, as you can see, now the resource is free. Basically now this pad is free and you can assign some other resource to it. Okay, so then what you gotta do is you go back to the menu and check out the next setup is resource pinIO 1. Okay, and go back to Betaflight, type it, and you wanna put the name of the pad. Okay, the name of the pad that you got free, this was the serial TX2. If you can remember it, it's basically, it's still right here. So this was A02, okay? So I write here A, leave a space of course, A02, enter, opala, pinIO 1, okay? And A02, okay? And now what it does is this pinIO 1, or IO, or 1 and 0, whatever you want to call it, it's now set to this pad. And basically what it does is you can assign a mode to it. Of course, don't forget to write save. The last thing what you want to do in the CLI setup, it's set up the pinIO box. So you type this, set pinIO box equals 40, comma, minus 1, and so on and so on. Just copy and paste this, okay? Just copy and paste it in your CLI. Okay, you come here, you paste to your CLI, you press enter, it will say pinIO box set to 40. Don't worry that this 255, 255, 255, that's how it's supposed to go. And don't forget to type safe at the end, okay? I'm not gonna enter now because I set it up on another TX. But you can basically do on anyone, doesn't matter. What you're gonna do next is, wait, my board always disconnects here, no, no way. Okay, so what do we do here? Let me connect my battery very fast. Hope it doesn't explode anything. Okay, so you go to your modes and you see at the bottom, now you have a brand new mode which appears, and that's user one. That's basically this pinIO. This is the digital input signal. As you can see, I set it up on one switch. You can assign it to any switch what you want. And when it's on, it sends a signal. When it's off, it sends a signal, okay? So basically that's how the chip knows how to flip between the cameras. And that's how you can switch between the two cameras. Now, the interesting thing is, of course, when you fly backwards, your controls are backwards. So what I did here is, on my Tyrannus, what is this? On this Horus, what I did here is I set up in the mixers channel 1, which is the ailerons. Sorry for the stupid cameras, it's not anything checking about it. I set it up, as you can see here. That was better, I think that's better. Okay, no, that's not even better. Whatever, just don't pay attention to it. What you wanna be careful is here, okay? This is how my channels are working. Sorry for the stupid lighting. So when I move left, my channel is going to the right. Of course, when I move right, it goes to the right. When I move left, it goes to the left, okay? The weight is 100. This is how it normally should go. And then when you flip a switch, okay? When I go left, it goes to the right. When I go right, it goes to the left, okay? So I reverse the channel, which means basically when I fly backwards, I still can use the normal controls and the drone should fly normally again. And you have to assign exactly the same to the elevator as well. So, and this is how it looks like. You go to edit and you assign a switch in one position. It's going to be minus 100. And then when you go back, you make a copy of that line, hold it, copy, paste it, and assign for the other position of the switch the negative, okay? And basically I assign this to the same switch, which switches between the cameras, so when I flip the camera, my controls are flipping backwards as well, and I don't have to do anything strange. And I can fly it backwards with the same aileron and elevator or pitch and roll as I fly forward, and basically my controller is doing all the thinking and I'm concentrating on making epic flights. Yeah, that's all. If you have any question, I'll be happy to clear them for you.